sounded like this the rest of the fucking night. So, well, I don't know who dick over here. That shit did. I'm sorry. I appreciate you coming out to support me, bro, but who dick is where it's at from now on. I mean, cheer one up to the next one, fucker. Shit, damn. I've been cleaning my dick off. But it's almost 10 o'clock, the gates are closing, I gotta hurry up. Why do white people always say that shit? What's it like to live on the reservation? What's it like to live in Chubbuck or Pocatello? We don't fucking live in teepees anymore. Most of the time. We don't ride horses all the time. Sometimes yes, sometimes no. But that's white people shit. White people, and I can say white people because I'm half white, so if you get offended, I'm sorry. I don't get offended, I'm just off. It took a yo, I'll wait to, for some of you to catch that joke. Half of offended is off.
Oh shit, he got it! Oh my god!
That fucking wagon burner told a fucking good joke. Now why do white people always come up to Indians and say, I'm Cherokee, my great-great-grandma was a Cherokee Indian princess. Bitch, just cause your mom and dad had sex in a Jeep does not make you Cherokee. Get the fuck out of here. But I mean, growing up Native, and I didn't really know I was white until I was like, maybe 14 or 15 years old, I finally came to the realization that my mom is white. My grandma was a full-blood Indian, and she looked white, because she never went outside.
Hey!
What? Grass. Oh, I get it. Hey, that was a fucking Indian joke. I'm, hey, how are you? Hey, how are you? Is that what you guys wanted me to say? I don't have my warp on it, so I can't chant. My bad. It's at home, drying off. I know, right? Oh, but growing up, like, I didn't really realize I was white. Until, like I said, until I was like 14 or 15, because my mom, she did bead work. She cooked Indian talk. I love fried bread. Who's there had fried bread before? Calm down, auntie. Shit. Who let auntie in here?
Woo! Fried bread! Nah.